Hi there, in this video, we are going to connect our pages up. You can see the little wires there. We're gonna preview it and we're gonna make our wireframe interactive. Watch this, ready to click the button. Jumps to a different page. Go back to the homepage. It's simple, but quite the milestone in our course. Let's go work out how to do prototyping now in XD. All right, time to add interactivity. We're gonna get this button to go first. So we're gonna click on the blue button, not the text in the middle. So I've got it selected and we're gonna switch to from design to prototype. Okay, so you'll toggle between these quite a bit when you're building a wireframe and a mockup. So design does all the design stuff. You can see over here changes. I can do fill and fonts and stuff. Prototype gets quite simple. What ends up happening, the big difference is, see this like little box? I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so you can see it. Okay, this little tab appears. So no tab, tab. This guy is really handy. Click, hold, and drag. So when they click this blue button, it's gonna go to this start trial. And you just drag it to the side. You can see it can go anywhere in here. As long as it goes blue, see, not blue, blue. Just drag it here, let it go, and you'll see it connects to whatever the middle of the artboard is. You can see it's dived down here. That now is connected. Let's just see what it does by default. So to preview that, you click this little play button up here. Click on it. Launches this like little preview window, and you can see it's separate from XD. It's this kind of separate little window, and if I click on it, ready? Ah, cool, huh? Basic navigation. We're kind of trapped here now. We can't get back. So we're going to close it down, hit the little red box. To go back, in our case, we're going to click on the logo. It's really common on a website and an app. If you click on the logo, you go back to home base. So with it selected, I can click, hold, and drag it, and it goes back here. So we ignored this before, okay, this little pop-up little window. We're gonna leave it all at the moment by default and have a look at a bit more in a second, because I wanna show you how to preview. So hit this little play button, remember, play, we click on it, home button goes back, play, that's fun. Okay, but this window, you can close it, reopen it, close it, reopen it. If you are like me and you are working with more than one screen, not everyone is and you don't have to, but I'll just quickly show you here on my phone what I do.
This is my setup. So I've got a MacBook Pro. It's nice, it's portable, but the screen's a little small. So I fix that by plugging it into this big LG monitor. LG do some really cool 4K monitors. Cheap enough. Like I think it was like 400 US, so it's not cheap, but pretty cool. Anyway, so what you end up doing is, remember we hit preview before, okay, and it appears, appears here, okay, and we kind of have to close it down to get back to XD. So what I end up doing is clicking, holding, and dragging it over here, so it just appears on this window. Cool, huh? And I never close it down, just stays open. And the cool thing about that is, if I zoom in, hang on, I need to put my hands down for shortcuts. Sorry. All right, I need a cameraman following me around. I don't have that. So I've zoomed in really close here, okay? I'm gonna go even closer. Real close. So this, you see the screen there? But you see over there, it's still at its normal size. So you can be designing in here and doing things and actually just checking it over there to see whether it's the right size rather than going back to 100%. The other thing is it's a live preview. So I'm gonna kind of see if you can see both of them. See the giant blue button on the right? Okay, I'm not sure if it's on the left or right in the video, I get confused. But if I click and drag it, can you see it's dragging on both? Okay, so it's live preview, which is super handy. The other thing I want to show you is something, you can see it's quite thin there, okay, it's not, and if I try and make it bigger, you might have done this already and you're like, oh, well, it's going to make it bigger, and it does this, and the black bars up here. Why is it showing me black bars? It's because over here, if I go back to design view.
So back here in Camtasia, I've switched back to from prototype to design, and I'm going to move across, click on my artboard homepage name, okay, zoom out. Remember this, viewport height? Okay, the viewport height is what's determining that kind of what you see on that laptop. So what you can do is you can adjust this and that will give you a taller box on that laptop. The only problem with that is that we're kind of designing for the 768, so we want to just keep that little letterbox window so we can only see that much so we know what's up kind of above the fold. But that can be a bit painful when you're working. So we'll jump back to the cell phone now and I'll show you kind of how it works.
All right, so you're back. And what we're gonna do is go to prototype. Actually, no, be in design. And remember, you can change it over here in viewport, but you can also just drag this line. And this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna drag that line up and down, And watch this, up and down, you can see. So if you go too far, it's gonna try and put too much into the viewport and your laptop, or my laptop screen, can't show it. I wanna find just this happy medium of that. Okay, so my viewports ended up being at 1043, and it's good for previewing on this, but I need to realize that, remember, the fold kind of finished up here, so I just need to be conscious of that. But I can't deal with the black bars, so I just adjust my viewport to help me show on my laptop. How confusing was all of that? Hopefully it wasn't too bad. Let's jump back out now. All right, one quick little thing is, loads of people ask me in different videos what monitor that is, because I always talk about it. So I'm just going to show you here so that you can go off and Google it and figure it out if you want to buy it. That's at the top there. It is the LG 27UD88W. I bet you can't buy that anymore. It's about a year old now. And depending on when you're watching this video, it could be like 20 years old. But it'll have family members that you can buy. So don't go and buy it. You don't have to. But people email me all the time about that. So I'm just trying to cut that question right out of there.
All right, I apologize. I had to look at some of that video I just shot on the cell phone. It was average. Not a cameraman. I hope you found it useful though. And last things I want to kind of just quickly tick off for this kind of basic prototyping. We're going to do like full-on prototyping later on when we've got our kind of high resolution version going, or high fidelity. Okay, so at the moment though, we're just going to cover all the basics, what we need for our wireframes. So a couple of other little things is, if I click on this, go to prototype. If you need to break the wire, okay, so say you're like, oh, I don't want to connect that anymore. There's two things you can do. The easiest is to click, drag, and just let go in no man's land, and it will just kind of snap back to its home. The other thing you can do, I've undone that, is you can click on it and say, I'd like it to go to this. So you're saying, I want it to, when this button is tapped, I want to transition to this page. Okay, which is our start trial, and that's the name of the artboard up there. You can just say none, and that gets rid of it as well. The other thing you can do with that trick is, let's say you're in here really close, and like we've got two artboards, and it's pretty easy, but you can have hundreds of artboards. It's not uncommon. What you can do, instead of trying to drag to like the 100th artboard, it's too, like, it's just too hard. You can click on this and say, actually, I don't want to drag anymore. Dragging's cool, but choose an artboard. I'm going to click start trial, and you can see it's done the wire. I'll zoom out. It's connected it instead of dragging it. It's just another way of doing it. The other thing is, you can kind of see it here. If I have black arrow, click in the background, I'm on prototype, and I go, edit, select all. So Command A on a Mac, Control A on a PC to select all. You can get this kind of nice, you can see all the wires going all at once. So you're like, have I done all the buttons? It's really easy to see in this case. Okay, and the one you don't have done is start trial. I was playing around with that in the break. So you don't have this one. So that's the one we do need. So start trial goes to the same box. So I'm going to click, hold and drag it and connect it. And this one here goes back when it's done. All right, that is the intro to prototyping and using the live preview on a different monitor. Let's jump into the next video.
Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up. It really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.